Futures trading is risky and can result in substantial financial loss. Never put a futures position on without a stop loss order in place.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, traders from across the globe. Welcome to Short Term Trading Live with Oscar. We have been kicking some butt, boy. We've been right, what, Thursday, Friday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday? And I think we're going to be right again tomorrow. But I ain't going to test the S&P again. Hey, nobody's that good. S&P is going without me. Whatever it does tomorrow, I don't want to know. It does have a characteristic, though. I've mentioned to you once before, S&P has this weird characteristic. If it puts in the top and it doesn't follow through, you get a couple of down days right afterwards. But this doesn't look like one of those times. This looks like a nice breakout. But I'm not going to test it. I've been right for too many days. We all have. We've been doing good together. Thanks to the stars, we're doing good together. But this could happen. It may not. It's too subjective. I'm going with the NASDAQ for tomorrow. S&P put its high in. NASDAQ hasn't done that yet, so it's got some room on the upside. The Omni tells me go with it. Let's go with a NASDAQ trade. With that in mind, NASDAQ, the Omni's higher. NQ870 Electronics, ENH7 for the Mini. I'm going to buy 1821 to 1819. That's my buy level. We're about 1825 right now in the overnight. My sell stops go below 1811. Put your sell stops in below 1811. Profit objective is 1846 to 1848. Be out by the close today. Keep this in mind. Resistance 1836 to 1838 on the way up. If we get lucky and buy these, and we get really lucky and we see 36, 38, you make a decision there whether you like to stay in or not. Of course, I'll flash update you if I'm ready to go. If it breaks through that level and it looks solid, 1846, 1848 should be your objective. So, buy the NASDAQ, look for 1821 to 19 on the buy level. Your stops go below 1118. A little bit of a risk there, 1811, excuse me, a little bit of a risk there. But you're going to get some volatility after putting in highs like we did in the S&P and the Dow. Of course, you're going to get volatility across the board in the indices. So the stop's got to be a little bit larger tomorrow. Again, I still like the S&P, but it's got some characteristics that make me say not tomorrow. Another thing came up on the radar for you cotton traders. Corn, cotton, they're planting a lot of corn. They're going to plant less cotton. I don't know. Sounds good to me for the summertime. Near term, we're looking for 54.35 in the cotton. CTH is the floor symbol. I didn't actually look up the electronic symbols. You guys do your homework on that. So the cotton, I think, looks bullish here. 54.35 near-term target. Omni is green. Omni's going up, bullish. 52.95 is the support zone. If you're looking to get long somewhere in there, 52.95 is probably not a bad spot. It's not a hardcore trade recommendation as this is. I'm just pointing you guys towards that market and telling you I see something brewing there. With that in mind, we've had a good week. I'm not going to push it. You know, a couple of trades for tomorrow. Keep your eye on the NASDAQ. Always, always, always place your sell stops. Always, always. In fact, a couple of questions came in. I wanted to give you a quick lesson, I guess, on sell stops, buy stops, and the placement of such. If I give you an order to buy at 1821, 1821 to 19, let's say you choose 1820 at your buy spot. You're going to buy one at 1820, your sell stop's 1811. Place the sell stop first, just in case something goes wrong. Let's say while you're typing, tink, 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 or calling the floor, or however it is you place your orders, you place one to buy at 1820, the president gets taken away by a Martian, and the market goes, well, boom, to the downside. You never had a chance to place your 1811 sell stop. You're stuck long the market. Same scenario. First you call or you start typing and you type sell one at 1811 stop before you get a chance to buy your buy order, right? To put your buy order in. And let's say a Martian's come again, boom, president's gone, and the market dumps. You'll end up short and you'll catch it on the right side. It's safe to place your sell stops and buy stops first. Conversely, on the upside, if I give you an order to buy at 18, to sell it at 1821 and your buy stop is 1830, let's say, place the buy stop first. For the same reason, let's say you're typing, you put your buy stop in, and the market explodes for some crazy reason. You get long into the move, as opposed to if you put your sell order in first without the protection, you end up short with no way out. Stop is your best friend, but placing it correctly is very important. Believe me, if you are a short-term, full-time trader, this will happen to you from time to time throughout your career. A day will happen, news will come out, as you're typing, the market's just gonna go away on you. If you're placing orders unlike a professional and your stops aren't in first, you will be a statistic. One day, you'll see, they'll carry you out. That's the way it works. Always place your stops, okay? I'm not gonna give anything else for today. Subscribe to me when you're at my YouTube website, www.youtube.com/futuresanalysts. If you're there viewing a video, hit subscribe. I'll give you my videos the moment they come out. You need to get on my flash updates database. If tomorrow I'm long this and my 1811 stop and we start to move higher and I'm going to change that 1811 stop and move it up to 1817 or 1820, I can't tell you unless you're on my flash updates database. The flash updates are what I use to let you know that I'm making changes to my resting orders and you guys should change yours. Email me at futuresanalysts@gmail.com. Ask me to get on your on my flash updates lists. I'll put you on. You can call me at 718-351-2266. Remember, the flash updates are important. Remember, stops are important. Remember that we've had a good run here. Bulls and bears make money and pigs eat sugar honey iced tea. That's what I've been told all my life. Don't be a pig. Don't be a pig. Be a bull or a bear. If tomorrow you've had a good week, the last 5 days, 6 days have been good to you, take tomorrow off trading maybe. Put a one lot on instead of a two. Don't make it, give it back Friday. That's my little lesson for today. Good luck trading. Happy Friday. I'll give you guys another one tomorrow night. Go get them, traders.
Futures trading is risky and can cause substantial financial loss. We do not claim or guarantee that you will profit from the information provided. That being said, I am a 24-year seasoned trader on and off the floors. This is how I've made my living for many, many years. Good luck trading.